segment, we will discuss the implementation of a decimal adder or a single bit BCD adder. So we know what BCD numbers are. BCD stands for binary coded decimal. So we have a 4-bit binary representation for all the decimal numbers. So where 0 is represented by 0000, 1 is represented by 0001, and so on up to 9, which is represented by 1001. So these are BCD representation of the decimal numbers. Now, if we want to add decimal numbers or two BCD numbers, so I have 4 bits, A0 to A3, then I have 4 more bits, B0 to B3. So we have 4 bits. For example, let this be 0001 and let this be 1000. So I need to add these two. Now there can be carry in from the previous stage, right? So you can have a carry in from the previous stage, and finally we get carry out to the next stage, and finally we get the coded decimal output. So this happens to be a decimal adder. Now this coded decimal output should also range between 0000 to 1001. So this also should be in BCD format. So what should be the circuit within so that I get a BCD representation at the output? So now we have to add two numbers, and let us see what are the conditions are to design a single bit BCD circuit. Now we have two cases. Now if this is A and this is B, so A is a 4-bit representation whose minimum value can be 0000, and B is also a 4-bit representation whose minimum value can be 0000, and we have C in, so C in can also be 0, right? So this is the case where all the inputs are 0. A is 0, B is 0, C in is 0, so the output is also 0000, right? So the output is also 00, so let me call this as S. S not to S3, the output is also 00, and finally C out is also 0, right? So you have A, B, C in and C out. So let us represent A3 as MSB, A0 as LSB. So let me interchange them. So I have A3 as MSB, A0 as LSB. Okay, so here we have a condition where I have a minimum output of 0. So what can be the maximum? The maximum is where A is 1001, which is nothing but 9. So this is A3 to A0. So this is the maximum value. What is the maximum value for B? It can be 1001, which is again 9, B3 to B0. And C in can be 1. So I have 1. So what are we doing? We are adding 9 plus 9 is 18 plus 1, 19. So 19 is the maximum value which we would get when we add two BCD numbers with carry in being equal to 1. Okay, so now when we add these two numbers, I should get 19. So I need to have 1001 and a 1 carry out. So this is what I need to have. But we do not have BCD adders, but we do have binary adders. So in such a case, when I add these two numbers, 9 plus 9 is 18 plus 1, I get 19 in binary. Okay, so let us see the conditions where we get a binary representation and not a BCD representation, and what should we do to get BCD representation. So if the added sum, or if the sum is between 0 to 9, there is no problem. For example, if A is 4, 0, 1, 0, 0, and say B is 2, 0, 0, 1, 0, I would get a number 4 plus 2 is 6, which is 0, 1, 1, 0, which is within this range. Okay, so the output is in BCD format. So there is no need to worry. But if I have a case where I get 1010, that is from 10 onwards up to 1111, which is 15. Say I'm adding 5 plus 5. 0101, 0101, I will definitely get 1010, which is 10. Okay, so when two BCD numbers are added, that is two 4-bit binary numbers are added, if I get a value between 10 and 15, we have to add 6 to get its equivalent BCD representation. So we have already seen that in BCD addition, right? So I need to add 6. So if the added sum, is in this range, so when do I need to add 6? So add 6. If I have a number ranging from 0 to 9, do I need to add 6? No. But if when I add two 4-bit binary numbers, if the output is in the range 10 to 15, then I need to add 6. So I put a 1 here, which indicates I definitely need to add 6. So when I add 6 to 10, its binary equivalent is 16, which is 10000. So its binary equivalent is 10000. So therefore we need to add 6 when the binary added result is within 10 and 15. So when I add 6 to 10, I get 1 followed by 4 zeros, which is the BCD representation of 10, 1, 0. Right? So I need to add 6. I definitely need to add 6 when the added result is between 10 and 15. Between 1010 and 1111, I need to add 6. So we need to add 6. But is the maximum result 15? No, the maximum result is not 15, but the maximum is 19, which is 19. Okay, now in this case, when I add two 4-bit binary numbers and when the value is between 0000 and 1111, carry out is equal to 0. There is no carry obtained. Okay, so condition 1, we need to add 6 when the added result of the two 4-bit binary numbers is between 10 and 15, is between 1010 and 1111. Okay, so this is one condition. The second condition, when do I need to add 6? I need to add 6 if the added result is between 16 to 19. Is in the range 16 to 19, right? So if I have, for example, I have 1000, which is 8, 1000, which is again 8. When I add these two, I get 0000 with a 1 carry. So I get carry out. Okay, so whenever there is carry out, then in that case, I also need to add 6. So I get 1 and 4 zeros. If I add 6, I get 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0. So this is 1 and this is 6. So which is nothing but a BCD representation of 16. Okay, so we need to add 6. For two conditions, we need to add 6 when the added result when the added 4-bit binary result is between 1010 and 1111. So this is the first condition. So here when the added result is within 10 and 15, C out will be equal to 0. So this is one condition. So when do I need to add 6? The other condition is when the added result is between 16 to 19, when C out will be equal to 1. So these are the two conditions when we need to add 6. Okay, so let us see how we can design a BCD adder, right? So we basically have a 4-bit binary adder, and this 4-bit binary adder has to be converted to a single digit BCD adder. So I have a 4-bit binary adder. So there are two inputs. So we have A3, A2, A1 and A0, and similarly we have B3, B2, B1 and B0, and carry in from the previous stage, and this is carry out. Okay, so in order to distinguish the carry out of binary and carry out of BCD, so let me call this as an intermediate carry. So let me call this as CB, carry from the binary adder. And these are the outputs. So let me call this as P3, P2, P1 and P0. Right? So again we have another binary adder, 4-bit binary adder, right? So again there are 4 line inputs. So let this be X3, X2, X1 and X0. Y3, Y2, Y1 and Y0. Okay, so I connect P3 to Y3, P2 to Y2, P1 to Y1 and P0 to Y0. Okay, so I've connected them. So I get the 4-bit binary added result here. Okay, so now the question is, when do I need to add 6? If the added result is between 0000 and 1001, there is no need to add 6. But we need to add 6 for two conditions: when the added result is between 10 and 15, and when the added result is between 16 to 19, when C out is equal to 1. C out is equal to 1. Right? So this C out, which is nothing but CB of the first stage, right? So when this is 1, we need to add 6, okay? And we also need to add 6 when the result is between 10 and 15. So we need to have a K-map and check what would be the output, what would be the condition there, right? So I have a 4 variable K-map. Okay, so we have P3, P2, P1 and P0. Okay, so 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. So we need to add 6 when the added result is between 10 and 15. So we have, this is 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15. Okay, so these are the values, isn't it? So the values of these are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Okay? Right? So I have a 1 which indicates that 6 has to be added. Okay? So this is only an indication that I need to add 6. So I need to add 6 when the added result is in the range 10 to 15. So 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. I put a 1, and when we combine these 4 and we combine these 4, okay, so when I combine these 4, what do we get? We get P3, P2, okay, and for this combination of these 4 ones, we get P3 and P1, right? So therefore, the result, the function is P3, P2 plus P3, P1. So we need to add 6 when it is P3 into P2. P3, P2, pass it through an AND gate, and then P3 and P1, pass it through another AND gate and give it to the OR gate. So what is the final function? The final function for me to add 6 would be P3, P2 plus P3, P1. So this is P3, P2 and this is P3, P1 plus the carry what we get from the 4-bit binary adder C. Okay, so this is 1 when carry from the 4-bit binary adder is 1. This is also 1 when the added result of these binary digits, okay, or BCD digits, single bit BCD digits, is in the range 10 to 15. Okay, so this output is 1 for these two conditions. So this is now connected to X2 and X1. Okay? And X3 and X0 are given to 0. Okay? So we get 0, 1, 1, 0. We are adding 6 for these two conditions when the added result of these two is in the range 10 to 15. Or when the carry from the 4-bit binary adder is 1. Okay, so finally what do we get? We get the added output, BCD output. So the added BCD output is obtained here. S3, S2, S1, S0. Okay. So this carry, of course, is 0. Okay. And we have the final carry here. So how is my circuit? The circuit is this. I feed in the carry input from the previous stage, which goes to the 4-bit binary adder. Then we have BCD numbers, two single digit BCD numbers, which are given to A3, A2, A1, A0, B3, B2, B1, B0. So we are adding these two. So the intermediate carry is given to the OR gate. Okay. And then we have another 4-bit binary adder to check when 6 is added. So 6 is added to the intermediate result for two conditions. When the added result obtained here is in the range 10 to 15, we are adding 6. Or when the intermediate carry, what I get, CB, is equal to 1. So we are adding 6 there. And finally, we get the added BCD output with the carry output here. Okay, so this is how we can design a decimal adder or a single bit BCD adder using two 4-bit binary adders.